It's a magnet.
Hello. Today we're demonstrating magnetic levitation using a giant magnetoresistance sensor and reference circuitry. GMR sensors have the sensitivity and range for this type of application, and they have a flexible interface. We have a solenoid with a GMR sensor on this board and control circuitry inside. The control circuit runs on 5 volts, and a power operational amplifier drives the solenoid. We could just use a PWM controller for the power amplifier, but we have a bunch of these in the lab. The control circuit uses a differential amplifier reference circuit for our Wheatstone bridge analog sensors. It has a gain of 20, which gives us close to full-scale output over the sensor's linear range. The input resistors are 100 times the bridge resistance to avoid loading the bridge. The amplifier bandwidth is the gain bandwidth product, which is a megahertz for this op amp, divided by the gain, which works out to 50 kilohertz for this circuit. Of course, we could add capacitors in parallel to the 10 megohm resistors to reduce the cutoff frequency. This is a versatile circuit. For example, we could put another sensor on the other side of the solenoid to cancel the solenoid field and sum it in like this. But we're just using one sensor for this demo. Here's the complete schematic. This big power amplifier is slow, so we added some derivative signal to improve stability. So you can see, we can levitate the magnet and the closed loop control keeps it in position. When we disconnect the solenoid, the magnet drops. We've seen that GMR sensors are ideal for closed-loop control because they're sensitive, work over a wide field range, and have a flexible interface. Click email or call us for more information or to order sensors.